side of me says stop so you don't blow. The other side says what would I stop for?
Opposite as the day and night, as different as the sun and moon.
Does Tubbex have white HP? Tubbex have white HP and Mongo can't find him. That's the game.
And Mongo finds him! Runs back into the store! Let's go! Let's fucking go, boys! Let's fucking go! We are so good! Let's fucking go!
Cracked! Now here! Maybe spam these kids a bit. I think it's a full trio.
Go.
I'm going.
Go up, bro.
Not up, bro. Don't go that way. Spam this metal. All the F1, everyone spam this metal.
We got shot out.
I'm on HP. I'm dead to storm.
I'm down.
Same.
I have no mats.
Go together, low ground. Chill, Jason! Mitrov, got zero ammo! Zero ammo, bro!
He's
28!
I'm taking this! He's 28! I just didn't have 28!
I have one.
No build!
Watch out, I'm taking this, sir.
Bouncer?
Dead! Let's go! Let's fucking go, boys! Let's fucking go! We are so good! Let's fucking go! But we actually might get contested right now. So.
Yeah,
no, that's the team.
I have the best roll.
I'm landing on AR on the roof.
One HP on this kid, I killed one! No, 1 HP!
71, Mitro.
I don't have dump.
Get the other chest, Mitro.
They're coming inside.
No,
I couldn't build.
No.
You got a purple point. No.
Bro, I...
Where is it?
Anas, bro, I killed two and I hit 190. Bro, you don't know how much damage I did!
Or something.
105!
Nice. They're getting sprayed, wait a bit. Maybe we can get them sprayed.
They're bots.
He didn't even heal.
100! What is being 36 way?
Get in. On me, 80 crack. Get in. Crack. Dead. Where are you?
Dead, let's go!
Nice.
I'm gonna build. Mitro, you can't get hit, bro. Wait, you're dead. What?
I'm dead.
How did we die? No. You gotta build me. Mitro, you need to go back.
Pick up the mat.
Oh. What the fuck is this? I thought no one tied. Yeah, that's why I can't really go on the boat.
They're pushing, bro. They're pushing. They're over here.
Pushing you?
You guys, we're behind you.
Oh.
Are they close?
They're on the hill, bro.
I got impulses.
I'm
impulse into the rift, bro.
He's right here. He's right on my marker.
He's on me.
Are you good or not?
I'm dead. No. They're all in him.
Shoot them in the back, me.
I'm dead.
I have 20. Under. Wait, on
I'm dead, bro.
What's wrong?
I can try and hit. Hit 122.
Nah. Oh my god. They're shaking.
I need to rift. We should have went backside of sweaty, bro.
They would have killed us out of the air already. They hit three times our drop. Bro, you need to go come to me or something, bro.
I know. What are we gonna loot?
I don't know, nothing. Game's over.
It's not fucking over, bro. Shut up.
I have an AR and a grey AR.
Get my card if you can. Oh, I can't probably.
It's impossible.
I don't think they got the llama though.
Oh, chug splashing a sniper.
You need to get it, I think you need to get it. You need to start going now though.
Oh, I need to chug. Mitra's running away from me.
The salty team killed me by the way. So they're gonna come back.
Mitra, we need to chug splash.
Oh, I'm looting. This is.
Okay, we can't get his card then.
They're probably camping it, bro. They're not pushing, they're just camping the card.
Just getting reefed, man.
They're rifting. They're gonna rift on Salty.
Just run, bro.
I'm just running.
Is there a car?
Yeah, they're rifting on Salty. They're rifting on Salty.
Yep, if they run on me, I'm dead.
Yeah, we're dead. GG. For fun, fuck.
Show quick to me, bro.
Yeah, I'm dead. I hate this game. I hate how you can get griefed.
Just help me, bro. Great up. Where they are.
Oh, I hate how you can die griefed!
You have honestly quite larger than a target on your back. It is a missile silo. It's a huge red X that everyone is looking for and trying to figure out where you are. You can even see Jonas, Duck on Top, Andalux marking some spots here. But currently, our number two ranked team, the only one who can realistically catch Mitra, Mongo, and Tayson, they're below that Storm Surge threshold. And right now, they're starting to take shots from the Rift. They're trying to get on the opposite side of this, but they're going to be very heavily split out. They're the orange triangles there. And they're being cut off on that rotation by Mitra, Mongo, and Tayson. X-Squeeze takes a ton of damage. Duck on Top down to just 20 HP. Janus desperately trying to find room to pop some of those mini pots. And you know the pressure's coming. Storm Surge is also coming. There's another team on their back. But Nems gets picked off. Sometimes all it takes is a couple bullets thrown in the right direction. And Nems going down there might have been that pivotal moment. The key thing, you're throwing a lifeline into the tournament. And it was Nems to push them above the Storm Surge. The two tags coming through. Andalex trying to snipe his teammates out with the bandage cannon, chucking slurp fishes. This is desperation defined from our second place team right now. Mongrel and Cult finally getting the conversion onto their first elimination, but they cannot go down here. They have to make this rotation, and it seems like it's almost too early in the game for this pivotal of an opportunity. But looking back in the storm, it's Mongrel and Mitro. They're the ones who got bogged down in the storm. They recognize that and got out of dodge. What a great rotation
from Andalix, Janice, and Exqueeze to get out of there. And now Tayson, Mitro, and Mongrel are in the same situation we talked about, desperately having to avoid. They're in the zone, and they're stuck. You can't all go down here. They have to find these Elims and the Siphons. There's no white heels. There's no campfires. They don't have a fishing rod to hit the double pool right there. As long as Doko doesn't give them the Siphon, they're going to go down for what will be the fourth game here. Mitro gets a Siphon ticked over. He's going to be on his feet. Tayson is down. The Elim will finally come through, but they have such a long run, and the 2 points isn't going to be enough, as we already saw the second place team rotate ahead of them.
This is the intensity that we're witnessing right here. The tournament is at stake on this rotation. Tayson, Mitro, and Mongrel, who have had a huge lead, now only sit with easily a victory royale from Andalix, Yanis, and Exqueeze, could take that lead away. And Tayson, their in-game leader, is down. It's all up to Mongrel and Mitro to hold on. And at the other side of this rotation is this, and they're being gatekeeped. This is an opportunity to be sighting out as well. Yanis is in trouble. Only down to one mini. Oh my goodness, Sundown. As Mitro gets knocked as well.
Yeah, Mitro going down on the side. Exqueeze knocked. Andalix knocked. Janice, if there was ever a time for heroics,
it's
now. And Lanouf said, we're going to close the door for them. It's going to come down to the final match with an 18-point lead on second place. Every single time.
Oh,
down
there 40, it is.
But he finds it. Wow. He gets the headshot. 39 damage above. 149 above now as some rifle shots above. And we talk about every single shot, every interaction mattering. Sometimes it's a singular bullet. And FaZe Mongrel potentially secures the tournament right there by beating back Storm Surge and preventing that damage from giving the MCES duo and Janice an opportunity to yank it away.
Oh my goodness, the intensity. Just beaming, you're just hoping that they could hit it. All the Mongrel, Mitro, Tayson fans out there, no doubt putting that energy right behind that energy beam, and it was holding on tight. And now look at this rotation. It's going to be so dangerous to make. You're going to have to go ahead and go all the way across the beach, all the way across this water, and already Andalix and Yanis and Exqueeze realize that, and they're gone. The question is, does Mongrel, Mitro, and Tayson moving out, and we might have a clash on this rotation between number one and number two. It could all go down in these moments right now. The grand championship is up for grabs on this treacherous aquatic rotation. Here we go, Sundown. It's about to happen.
And you can see, keeping an eye on that bottom right-hand corner, when we cut back, the green triangles are Mitro, Mongrel, and Tayson. There's the one you want to pay attention to. Currently behind on the rotation. Now keeping an eye, Janice, Andalix, and Exqueeze. They're on the front of your screen right now, but now we're going to hop back on board. Outside, looking in, no excess utility. However, the team in front of them, who they're spraying, they're marking it right now. They're saying, pour the shots into them. That's second place. We can finish it right here, right now. But look at how many triangles are in between them and the finish. They're going to have to push their way through here, and there's not a bunch of real estate. And one and two, wall to wall, Sancho. This is what we came here for.
We talked about being toe to toe. Who is going to be the big toe? As Thomas HC is lighting up the feed, but the focus is right here, right now. The grand finals. We have two, number one and number two, being neighbors for this brief moment. And for somehow, Mitro, Mongrel, actually, Andalix, they belted. They're gone. They went right below the waterfall, and that's going to be a brief moment to extend this match right now. But right on the heels on this rotation is Mongrel, Mitro, and Tayson, and they have to stay alive as long as possible. We're not even near the placement points. 24 right now. It needs to be the 17th place. And some of the lobby focus is creeping in. They gotta be careful when the bullets
underneath.
Are going in.
That's them underneath. That's the MCS duo underneath them putting pressure. Tayson, this could be it. They can't go down here. Tayson's down. Mongrel on 20 HP. Mitro on 20 HP. And what it looked like. They had it all boxed up when they had the trophy already on the shelf. The chickens were counted before the eggs were hatched, and now it all comes crashing down. The door is wide open. Andalix, Janus, X-Squeeze, aka Duck on Top, they only got one of those eliminations, but the 1 point is now going to close the gap, and now the math begins. They were 20 points down to start. Can they find the 19 points to make the difference here? It's all going to come down to match number 12.
And the rotation gets dangerous and more dangerous, because now they have to keep pushing into the northwest all the way through Coral Castle, and as well have to deal with the waterfall on the other side. They have yet to capitalize every time Mongo, Mitro, and Tayson. Throughout the entire day, the door has been open, and they have yet to walk through that door. This door is just not like any other door. At the end of this door is the Grand Finals Championship. It is time. It is your opportunity to clinch it, to go up and grab it, to seize it. Don't let it slip away. Let's go.
And now it's all going to be on to them. This is the story we talked about. Just one singular opportunity, but they have to take it. An opportunity is nothing if you're not able to have the ability to capitalize. And with only the shockwaves and the peppermints and no extra shields, very limited builds, the opportunity looks like it's slamming in their face. The door ever so slowly creeping in. Storm Surge, not gonna be an issue, but you see, they need every point possible. If they drop, Mitro and Mongrel get their trophy. They have the chance to steal it away, but it's going to be so incredibly difficult, as you said, because look at the number of triangles between them and the safe zone, and the ambush. Janus goes down, the solo champion falling there in a key moment when you need to have everyone together, when you need every placement point in every elimination. He falls.
Now, oh my goodness, it's up to Andalix, the duo champion here, to kind of form up and know the lobby focus is real. And when you're down to these kinds of mats, it's all but a matter of moments. It is second place on the ropes. Are they reeling? They might get knocked out right here, down to green HP, as Sweez and Andalix are holding on for their tournament life and the opportunity to get the first place. It's not going to be easy. Sundown, they have a brief moment to breathe, but look at that half in and half out. They're not safe at all. There's still danger arising. Can Andalix and X-Squeeze overcome the adversity and have an opportunity to at least get a victory royale and the overall championship?
They need the space, and we talked about being fortunate to even have an opportunity, but you have to be able to capitalize, and right now, they aren't getting that chance. There's too many people in between them. They don't have the resources. They have to find a key refresher, and right now, a smart path to go forward
seven
a little
builds.
Bit and over the side, but as you called out right there, seven builds, Sancho. Seven builds, 21 HP, and a dream of first place and an axe of champions as they begin to rat through the catacombs, but each door you break could potentially have a surprise on the other side, especially as you creep in and we can see the yellow tiles right through the side. But Andalix recognizes their door opens up. They can't take any fire. There's no excess shields, and this is the tournament right here. Mitro, Mongrel, and Tayson have been dropped. We're getting closer to placement points, but the only trio with a mathematical chance of catching them has their back against the wall. Nay, the wall, a massive mountain, as currently 21 HP, 121 between them, zero shields, two builds on Andalix. He has to find a snipe to make this happen.
One pump shot, one edit is enough to knock out Andalix and X-Squeeze, and that is why they're hoping. But look, Zone says, you know what? No way. You're going to have to go up the waterfall. Now, all of a sudden, we're at an all-time high in danger. The tournament right here is at stake. No doubt, Mongo, Mitro, and Tayson are happy, and this could be big. This could be big. This could be that refresher that they need. Let's see what that squeeze finds. A brief moment just to relax and just breathe a sigh of relief here, but they're not done yet. They got a lot of work to do as they're unable to clean up that knock.
Oh, and a bad shockwave! A bad shockwave separates Andalix and Duck on top, and this is horrible because Andalix has no build!
No!
We talk about being a fish out of water! He's a fish in the water, and now he's done! It's all going to come down to X-Squeeze, but they're into the placement points. It's a survival of the fittest, and how fitting. The story of EU has been the Lone Rangers and the clutch opportunity. X-Squeeze with the opportunity to rise here and to make it a historic moment. 34 players remaining, 16 trios left, but he has a pump, a epic burst, 10 builds, and a dream, and the dream is quickly dwindling like a candle. He tries to find a little bit of space, but it's not going to work right now. Zone is closing in. He needs a refresh. He doesn't have the tools to win the game with four more builds.
Oh no!
Somebody in his box! He finds the Dark Siberian Jake! Could be the gift that he needs! The damage still coming through. 43, 10 HP, and he's down! It's it! It's over! They don't rise to the occasion! Mitro and Mongo get their first Keystone victory right there. Tayson combines as well with his solo invitational one, and we're gonna ride out the final moments to see who can move up the leaderboard and earn themselves a little bit of cash.